Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn a behavior of AC parallel circuit. Before going to this module, let's consider a concept called as admittance. So basically, admittance is the reciprocal of impedance. Let's derive the expression of admittance. For that, let's start with the RL circuit. So I have a resistance in series with the inductor, and the impedance of this is Z and is given by R plus J XL. Unit is ohm, where XL is inductive reactance, and it is related to L with this formula XL equal to 2 pi FL. Now we need to find out the admittance for this. Admittance is denoted by Y. So it is the reciprocal of impedance. So Y equal to 1 by Z. So if I substitute Z over here, I will get Y as 1 upon R plus J XL, where XL is an inductive reactance. Since Z is a complex quantity, obviously its reciprocal is also a complex quantity. So let's represent Y in terms of a proper real and imaginary term. For that purpose, let's multiply by complex conjugate of the denominator, and that is R minus JXL. So I will get R minus JXL divided by, here I will use a formula A plus B, A minus B, that is A square minus B square. So it is R square minus B is JXL. So if I simplify, I will get R minus JXL upon R square. If I square it, I will get a J square, and J square is minus 1. So that minus minus will become plus over here, and it will be plus XL square. So Y I can write like this, R upon R square plus XL square minus J XL upon R square plus XL square. So this is the admittance of the inductive circuit. Here I am having two terms, one is the real and second is imaginary. So this real term R upon R square plus XL square is nothing but G, and G is a conductance. What is conductance? It is a reciprocal of resistance. And the unit of conductance is mho. Second term is XL upon R square plus XL square, and that is B. B is nothing but susceptance, and susceptance is nothing but reciprocal of reactance. And the unit is once again mho. So ultimately I can write Y as G minus JB. unit is mho. Now let's represent this with the help of a triangle. So first I will draw admittance triangle. And then I will relate this admittance triangle with already done impedance triangle. So admittance I am getting over here y equal to g minus jb. So if I represent this in a triangular form, it will be like this. G is the real part and minus jb, so in negative direction y axis you will have b, and this will be y. Phase angle phi is nothing but this between y and g. Corresponding impedance triangle, for that z equal to r plus j xl, it will be like this. R is the real term, plus jxl will come like this, and this will be z, where phase angle phi is the angle between z and r. So here I can say g is nothing but r upon r square plus xl square, and b is nothing but xl upon r square plus xl square. Same analogy I can use for RC circuit. So for RC circuit, I will have admittance triangle. For that, admittance y will be g plus jb, and it will be like this. This will be g plus jb will come vertically upward, and third line will be this angle phi, where g is the conductance and given by r upon r square plus xc square, and b is nothing but xc upon r square plus xc square, where xc is capacitive reactance. Corresponding impedance triangle, for that z equal to r minus j xc, and it will be like this. So in a parallel circuit, instead of a impedance, we will talk in terms of admittances. So in parallel circuit, what we will have? We will have several parallel branches whose impedances are given. Let's take Z1, Z2, Z3. So all these impedances are nothing but either series RL circuit or series RC circuit or series RLC circuit. What you have to do? You have to convert all the impedances into corresponding admittances. And then in parallel circuit, addition of all the admittances will give you total admittance in the circuit. And how the total admittance related to the voltage and current? It's very simple. Voltage V will be nothing but current multiplied by admittance. So rather talking in terms of impedances for parallel circuit, it will be better if you consider their admittances. So while solving problems, most of the times we take admittance whenever we deal with a parallel circuit. Thank you.